Father, pour in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Finally started at my new job. It's been such chaos lately that this is the first chance I've gotten in a while to write. And I finally can write in you, my dear diary. It seems to me like throughout my life people have always been betraying me and leaving me, but never you. You understand my feelings. Your pages take in what I write and understand what I say. My new job as a secretary has been hectic, but I believe I can make it work. My last job wasn't all that different. But the people there were just simply jerks. Enough said. Especially my last boyfriend, Rob. I can't believe he had the nerve to walk out on me at my first night together. Better yet, I never saw him again. I even called Robert's phone, and it was on, but he never called back. And all my other boyfriends did the exact same thing. Harry, what's wrong with me? Anyways, before I go to bed, I just wanted to tell you that lately I've fallen asleep at my desk and woken up with these really creepy drawings in front of me. And I know I drew them because, frankly, who else would be in my room? And even signed them. But I don't remember doing any of the sort. I was just thinking of seeing a psychologist or something, but they're just drawings. They can't hurt, can they? Once after waking up, I saw in my bathroom mirror that I had drawn an upside-down cross. I'd read somewhere that that's a sign of Satan. Then around me, I saw I had painted the entire bathroom. I wrote, so these three things continue forever. Faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of all these is love. Am I a freak? I've been putting all these pictures up on my wall every time it happens, save for the picture of the bathroom wall. They scare me, but if they're a part of me, I want to understand them. When I'm asleep, I hear voices. Once I woke up and in front of me I saw a picture I had drawn. It was a man looking to heaven all bloodied up. I thought it was a sign. I thought it meant I was supposed to kill myself. I even bought a gun and tried to, but I just couldn't bring myself to pull the trigger. Diary, I'm scared. But you know I try not to dwell on the past, so on to the present. I believe maybe this whole thing was just a phase and my life is going to look uphill from here. Already today, on the second day at my new job, I met this man. Another employee who seemed so confident and clearly flirty with me. He even suggested we get together sometime. So Diary, tomorrow, I think I will ask him if he wants to have dinner at my place. I just know he wouldn't leave me. He seems so kind. His name is Terrence, but I like calling him Terry. I think I'll try to draw a dove to get the whole scary drawing thing out of my system. Then I'm going straight to bed. Promise. Love, Jane.
so excited for the date tonight. I've had my eye on Jane since I met her. This is going to be great. I'm really nervous, but she seems 10 times more nervous and a little awkward. It's almost a bit cute.
I can't let Terry see any of these. I think I'm a freak.
Hi, Jane. I brought this.
Oh, thank you, Terry. That's so sweet.
Well, can I come in?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Come in.
Thanks.
Oh, hey, wait. Can you take your shoes off, please?
Oh, yeah, no problem. So, have you ever been in a serious relationship?
No, I would love to be in one, but it seems like men always leave me.
Well, I would leave you. Well, tonight was really fun. I'll see you tomorrow then.
Why? I mean, why leave?
Oh, okay then. What are you doing?
Jane isn't here anymore, Terrence. The voices in my head are telling me to kill you.
Get away from you, you freak!
So, Diary, tomorrow, I think I will ask him if he wants to have dinner at my place.
I'm really nervous, but she seems 10 times more nervous and a little awkward. It's almost a bit cute.